In this lesson, we are going to use ESP32 and ESP32 extension board from SunFounder and using the camera to take photo and store it in the memory card. Connected the battery. This is outside on the street. ESP32 starter kit from SunFounder. This is the best ESP32 learning kit from SunFounder. It has this ESP32 microcontroller, which has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. This board can do everything Arduino Uno can do or many other Arduinos can do, plus extra more features. Because we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, the possibilities are endless. You can get connected to the cloud or do the control or read information or values via your mobile device or your desktop or over the cloud from a far location. It comes with a camera extension kit where you can stream the video over Wi-Fi, either through the cloud or to your network. And also it comes with micro SD card where you can save images on the micro SD card, or you can write from the device any information, log the information on the device and read it back. You can power the board using this included 18650 lithium battery. And it has built-in charger where you can connect micro USB and charge the battery. The kit comes with 320 pieces of component that you can learn tons of projects. You can take photos by powering it up with this battery and take it like a photo camera, even though the quality might not be as satisfying as your mobile phone, but this is very cheap camera with this kit. It's acceptable, I believe. Now first let's insert this into the card. So we're just pulling this up like this, and because the metal connectors are at the bottom, these shiny wires should be facing down and the camera will be facing up. So we just insert it, make sure it's aligned up to this portion. You see here, it should be almost equal to this, and then press it. Now the camera is facing up. If I hold it, the camera is facing that way. And then for the memory card, as I've explained it in previous lessons, the maximum capacity cannot exceed 32 gigabyte, so you can use 32 or less. And all of these components are included in the ESP32 learning kit. The link to purchase it below this video in the description. Come to this page, docs.sunfounder.com. Scroll down until you see ESP32. Then click on ESP32 Starter Kit Main. On the left side, click on Arduino User. And then scroll down to 7.6. Take Photo SD. This is the documentation page where it talks that we are going to take photo using ESP32 camera to take photo and store it on the micro SD card. We just need the ESP32 and ESP32 extension board. Like this, and we are going to insert the camera and power it up, upload the code, which I'm going to explain it fully. And there are some settings which I'm going to explain it step by step, and then after taking photo we will see the photos on our computer. And here are the explanation for the code, which I'm going to explain it in the code section. When we are saving photos, the photos will be numbered like this in the root, and they will go from 0 to 255. The reason for that is that EEPROM is set to 1 byte, and that is 8 bit. So 2 to the power 8 is 255. If you want the photo numbers to increase, just change this to 2 or 3, which is within the code, and I'm going to show you. Camera resolution depends on the model. The model that we have is OV2640, and the resolution is 1600 by 1200 pixels. And this is the length, 1/4 inch or 1/4 inch. And there are other versions, as you can see, even lower version, but it seems the highest resolution is this one, OV5640. I'm opening Arduino IDE. Let's open our project by clicking on File, Open. On the left side, click on Downloads, then ESP32 Starter Kit Main on the right side. Double click to open it, double click on C, double click on Codes, and scroll down to 7.6. Here, 7.6, take photo folder, double click to open it, select 7.6, take photo SD, and click open to open it. Here, we have included ESP32 camera, Arduino, file system. This is for SD card, and this is also for SD card. This is for disable browner problem. These three, and then we have EEPROM, and here the size is 1, so this 1 means the maximum number goes to 255. And these are the pin definition for camera, AI Thinker. We are not going to change them, and all of these up to here. And picture number, this is the initial value. Inside the setup, we set the right pre-registration. This is for brownout disabling, and then we initialize the serial monitor with 115,200, and we have this variable called config, camera config, and we are setting values, and this has these following properties. So config.ladc channel, channel 0, ladc timer, and then all the pins. These are the defined pins, the constant that we are assigning, so we are not going to change it. This is the clock frequency for the microcontroller, and this is the format for the photo that we are taking. And here is the documentation page where we set this value. The values could be YUV422, grayscale, RGB, or JPG. So we are setting it to this value. These are all uppercase. So this is a frame size, and we can have any of these that we want. So this is a compression of the JPEG. And here we are setting the frame buffer count to 2. So it says if PSRAM is found, these are the setting, else these are the values that are set. Initializing the camera, so ESP camera init or initialize with the configuration which we set. And here all the configuration will be passed, and we check it. And the frame buffer is initially defined as null, and then when you take a picture, ESP32 frame buffer get, the value is here. If the buffer is not true or not available, then we get error. Print the error on the serial monitor. This is initializing the EEPROM. So we say EEPROM.begin, and then EEPROM size, which we defined it 1 at the top of the code. And here, then EEPROM read plus 1. We get the value, and we increment it. So that will be our picture number. And then we have to set the path. This is a string plus string picture number plus .jpg. So this will make whatever is the picture name, picture, for example, 2.jpg or whatever it is. And this is our path for the picture. And here from SDMMC, we are defining this by reference as FS. So this file system is created, and we print the path as a C string on the serial monitor, and then if open, we create a new file for the picture as a file, and if there is an issue, we print the error. Otherwise, we say if a file write, and then Otherwise, we set the frame buffer and frame buffer length. So one is for the image, the other is the length of size of the image, and it will be saved, printed on the screen, that's the path. So this is taking the photo and saving it, and this is printing it with actual full path and name. And this goes and writes the picture number to the memory, and then it will say commit. So this is taking the care of the taking picture and closes it. And then ESP32 frame buffer return, this will return it back. Now, in order to eliminate the saturated color, this portion has been added. So there is a for loop that the picture will be taken starting from shoot 0 to shoot number 4, 1 less than 5. And so this for loop runs up to here. You see this square bracket? All these, so this is taking picture, but only the fifth one will be saved. Now let's see how we can select the ESP32 board. We can click here under the select board and type here ESP32DEV. As soon as you type dev, you will see dev board. You can select it and click OK. So the board has been selected. Now we have to select the port. The other way to select the board is click on Tools, Board, ESP32, and select the ESP32 dev module. Now we have to select the port. If I click here, it shows two ports, and I don't know which one belongs to my device. Sometimes you will not see the number properly. So the best way to be sure, right click on the Start menu, go to the Device Manager, and you will see here the ports. If I click on this arrow, it will show me the ports. One is USB serial CH340, the other is USB serial device. And here, now it's connected. If I disconnect this, one of them disappears. The one that disappeared is my board. So 6 stays and 8 disappeared. If I connect it, so 8 is my COM port, CH340. Now 8 is my COM port and I can select it. Or I can click on Tool, Port, and here you will see it. You can select whichever you want. Ours is COM 8. Now we have successfully selected the board and the port. And this is very important. It must be done first. And here is a demonstration. I removed the microSD card and clicked to upload the code here. So it's completed. Let's insert this. And now let's take photo. I am facing it to the door side. Just pay attention here. That was one photo, and then let's do one more. Maybe facing this way. Let's remove this, insert it to my computer and show you. So picture 26, this was the picture, and 27. Let me show you the resolution. I'm right clicking, selecting properties or Alt Enter, and here you go to details and you will see the resolution, 1600 by 1200 pixels. And the depth bit is 24 bits. Connected the battery. Let me go outside and take some photos. And let's have a look at the photos that I've taken. This was the previous one. This is outside on the street. This seems saturated. And as you can see, when the camera is shaking, it will be blurred, so it should be very stable. So, these are photos.